Hey guys, welcome back to Rule the World. Last episode, you'll remember, we went to the End and we took on the Ender Dragon. It was an epic battle. He carried away the princess, but we did rescue her. We killed him, we took his heart, and we looted the End for all that it's worth. We got a whole bunch of ores and precious pearls and ender lilies. And then we got the hell out of Dodge through the portal that appeared when we killed the dragon. So this episode, it looks like the princess has been busy over here at her part of the compound, and she's going to show us what her and Baron have been up to with our Britannia setup. So let's check it out. There are all kinds of cool setups over here, including, well, if I remember rightly, this is a... Oh, hello. Here we go. Oh, hello. Your blacksmith and I have put our differences aside in aid of your cause. Oh, right, yeah, because I was going to say, you've got like a really sweet... I'm a lord. And the mechanical and the botanical. Bocanical. Bocanical? Metanical? What? I'm just trying to make a thing out of this. So it looks like, yeah, there's some pretty complex setups over here. We've got like an item dropper over here. Do you guys want to walk me through each one of these four stations one by one to say what they are? Because I could probably work it out, but it'd be much quicker if you guys could fill me in. By the way, I'm so happy to hear that you guys have been seeing eye to eye recently. I'm really proud that you can set aside your differences and not be assholes to each other, you know? Yeah. Awesome. Awesome, right. So yeah, walk me through what you guys have done. Right, so if I'm correct, this is the flower that creates all these Britannia flowers, and I tell you what, it's probably quicker if I just kind of tell you what I see, and you correct me if I'm wrong. Because we've got like a mana pool down here that looks like it's being shot at from the mana spreader up there. That's powering this amaranthus that's just creating loads of flowers around the edge. And if I'm right, I could probably use my fists to punch a flower, or two, or three or four, and they should get planted down again by the amaranthus. But I guess it needs more mana than it's got at the moment, because, oh yeah, it's got very little mana at the moment. So, oh no, it's full. So it's, oh, there we go. No, it's started to plant them. It's just not very quick. Oh, there we go. Berum's on the case, putting in some more mana into the system. Oh, pretty sweet. All right, so that's one of four taken care of. So that's a place where the mana's being shot. What's going on over here? What's all this stuff? Potatoes? Gormorealis. I don't know how you're supposed to pronounce this, but these are the flowers that eat food, right? These are the Britannia flowers that eat food and turn it into mana. So we've got, what's this? Some item droppers over here with potatoes in, and they are dropping potatoes next to the flowers. The flowers are eating them. That's creating mana, and it's shooting them over here. He set up some redstone, and oh, there's some redstone up there as well. Oh, no way. No, wait, hang on a sec. I can fly, can't I? Where's my tiara gone? I had a tiara. Oh, I've run out of mana. I need to go and recharge my greater band of mana. Bit of conflict here. So Baron set up the whole system, and Eldrifin, you planted the flowers. That's the perfect kind of combination of botany and blacksmithery. So what's going on over here? What are these flowers? Because these look pretty cool. Endo flames. Now I know what these do as well. These turn burnable fuel into mana. So coal, charcoal, anything that you can drop that's fuel will power these flowers. And then again, oh, it looks like you've set up the same thing over here with a redstone kind of system that ticks around. But there's no coal in here at the moment. A timer. And then when those tick around, it powers the flowers. Sends the beams over here. Oh, and I remember these guys, the Luniums. Every 5 seconds, wow. Well, no wonder you've run out of coal. Now, there's no real way for us to get potatoes or coal all the way from over there to over here. Do you think maybe we need another courier to kind of bring over potatoes and coal? I think that might be a good idea. Thing is, though, we might run out of coal because... yeah, it'd be great, but I don't know how much coal we've got left, because the quarry has probably dug up a lot of coal, I won't lie, but we're going to run out. Anything like that, anything you dig up, you can run out of at some point. Charcoal. Now, charcoal you can create by burning wood, so that might, you know, you can use wood to burn wood to create charcoal. So as long as you have infinite trees, and we could do that with some quarries, we would have infinite fuel for this thing, and all the potatoes grow infinitely as well. So if we set up another potato farm, maybe we'd have infinite potatoes for these as well. Well, that's a pretty cool system then. Let's have a look. There are flowers to power furnaces too. Oh, wow. So you can set it all up with the power of nature. That's pretty cool. I'm going to take a dig through some of these chests. A windmill might be better. All right, guys, call it. I know it's mechanical versus botanical, but I think we can arrive at a mutual solution that includes both of your expertises. So we've got like a whole bunch of dungeon loot in here. Some of this stuff I've never heard of, like cloaking from enhanced portals. I have no idea what that is. And what's this up here? Damage circuit from calculator. I know not to go anywhere near calculator because it always crashes my game. Iron ingots, I know what they are. A nuke virus, a stopworm. Oh, mana steel. I didn't know you could get mana steel from dungeons. Ender lily seeds as well, nice. Perhaps take some of the quartz so we might customize your wings. Oh, right, yeah, of course. Now, we made another set of wings for Eldrafin, but neither of us have customized our wings. At the moment, they're just base flugel tiaras. So let's take some quartz out of here. Where is it? There we go, 47. That should be plenty. Now, oh, I'm going to dump some of these mystical flowers somewhere as well. Do we have like a chest to kind of keep all the petals? I guess over here. Where is it? Oh, right. Show me. Oh, yeah, perfect. So we can just chuck our flowers in there. No sweat. We've got another jaded amaranthus in there, some books, some essence berries. Right, well, let's customize our wings because we want to be able to fly properly in style. Now, how do you customize your flugel tiara wings? Because if I go here at Britannia, and if I scroll down through the list, we can find the wings by adding different quartz to the tiara. Right, so there's all these different kinds of tiaras in the list over here, but the only difference is they have a different number at the end. Oh no, if I hold down shift, we can see the different types. So we've got an amulet that has no wings, a flugel, one winged angel, very Final Fantasy, ice fairy, wow, that sounds cool, very Elsa, phoenix from the flames, a black snow princess, okay, a lord of the pit, wow, that sounds a bit demonic, a sylph, now that sounds kind of elfy, and then mega ultra chicken. I have no idea what that is. All right, where's the princess gone? Okay, princess, take a look through the not enough items menu and tell me which kind of amulet you want. Now, I kind of think you'd make a good black snow princess, but you know, I'm not going to push it on you. You could also be a lord of the pit if that takes your fancy, but I wouldn't judge you if you chose mega ultra chicken either. Let us see what the Mega Ultra Chicken has in store. Oh no, I'm not sure if I should tell her. Do you have chickens in Alfheim? Do you know what a chicken is? She doesn't know what a chicken is, does she? It's a magical, huge magical creature of mythical power. It's like a dragon meets a griffin. Yeah, I think it embodies your kind of soul perfectly. All right, well, let's make you a mega ultra chicken tiara. And I'm going to go for a sylph one because I'm all about the obes and the fairies. So let's see. Mega ultra chicken, and this needs a sunny quartz. And then for the sylph, it needs elven quartz. My father spoke well of you and your friend. Oh, yeah, yeah, Lewis. Well, we were druids once. But that's changed. Right, so I need to put in elven quartz in mana infusion. No, wait, is this right? Alchemy catalyst, elven quartz, mana infusion. Is this right? So I just put, I just put the elven quartz in the normal quartz into a mana pool and it comes out as elven quartz. Is that correct? Is that how this works? There's not much. No, it's blue there. So I have to make elven quartz. How do I make this? The portal. Oh, right, of course. So if I throw normal quartz through, it'll come out this side. Right. All things elven, of course, come from Alfheim. Oh, the portal's down. Right, I need a flint steel. Yeah, there's plenty of power to keep this thing going. I guess maybe it just kind of like short-circuited or there was a power cut. Just your wand, right, of course. Ah, there we go, it's back up and running. Right, so if I throw some quartz through, it should come out the other side. Oh no, there we go. Elven quartz. And so now let's put it with my tiara and see what we get. And bam, wings of the sylph. Let's see what these things look like. Oh yeah, now this looks amazing. This perfectly matches my green armor. Oh yeah, this is amazing. I'll tell you what, do you want to try and make yours now, princess? How do we make sunny quartz? Oh, we need a sunflower wrapped in quartz. I see, right. Well, we must have a sunflower somewhere. In fact, I'm surprised I can't see one just on the horizon. Let's see if we can find one in the chests or something, because I know I probably have some in the warehouse, actually. Oh, also, it should be mentioned that we've changed all the gravel around Sjinterfell into this nice trodden dirt from Britannia. I think it looks nicer. There's like a slight little edge to it, so you can see the sides of the roads, but also it increases your pace. You can run quicker when you run around on trodden dirt. All right, let's see, sunflower. Yeah, we do, we've got 35 sunflowers. So I'm just gonna take one, put the rest back in. Oh, I can't, because we're full. Oh man, this thing is always just so full. All right, well, I'll make you this sunny quartz. Don't you worry. And now there you go. Plonk one of these with your wings, and let's see what a super mega ultra chicken looks like. Here we go. Moment of truth. Oh yeah, looking good. Actually, not as embarrassing as I was expecting. That actually looks kind of cool. And I think it suits you. Definitely suits the kind of yellow color of your... I thought the wings would be too big and grand for you. I thought you'd like kind of fall over because wings like that are crazy big, right? Chicken's really big. Chicken is like a really big animal, really big and powerful. And I thought you'd fall over because the wings are too big, but it looks like they downscaled the wings. So you're okay, yeah? Yeah, that's what I meant. Well, let's go. I need to go and charge up my mana ring. While we're here, actually, let's take a look around. I haven't checked my mailbox for a long time. Well, I've been checking it, but there's never anything in it, so there's not much point. Oh, we got some mail. Now we're even by purple_champion. What could this be? Let's take a look. I'm just going to read this over here. We have had our differences in the past, but you freed me from the chains that bound me to Blackwood. So to even our debt, here's a little bit of information. He's building an army, and it's coming for you. What? Lord Black... How does he know? Do you know? You have no idea what's going on, do you? Maybe I should fill you in. A while ago, we raided the castle of an evil lord that lives nearby. Now, I thought it was anonymous and I got away with it because no one saw me. We killed his guard, some kind of purple knight. I'm gonna assume that he knows now that because he had the first part of the god that we found that set us on this path. And I'm going to guess that he knows now that we took that piece. So now he's building an army and it's coming. Yes, exactly. Oh, what are we going to do? Well, this is way sooner than I assumed we'd have to go to war with him at some point, but I didn't think it would be this quick. We're going to need to set up some defenses really quickly. Oh my God. Well, we can fly now. Well, I can't actually. Let's go and charge. Have you got a ring of mana? We should get your wings charged. Defend yourself. Right, I'm going to need your help and Beram's, I think, to set up some walls around the way he's going to come from. I can build some troops, some grunts. I'll get some archers as well. An old Sipsy. Maybe we could give Sips a sword and he could help out too. But yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. We need to get to work and set up some defenses. Before we start, I've charged up my ring. Oh, what's Simon doing there? Charged up my ring, so now I can fly pretty much forever without having to worry about falling down. What I want to do now is make a chisel so that I can make some fancy cobblestone to go with some dark oak wood, and we can get some battlements set up around the front of the kingdom facing towards Blackwood's base. Now, if I remember rightly, we're going to need sticks. So we'll take out... Well, we're going to need loads of dark oak wood and also loads of cobblestone. So a few stacks of these should come in real handy. Now let's go and make a chisel so that we can make some fancy cobblestone. And there we go, a chisel. Now this is a beautiful piece of kit, the chisel. With a chisel, we can make our own custom kind of blocks that look a bit different to the regular kind of cobblestone and wood effect ones. Right, so this is where he's gonna come from. This is the edge of our kingdom right here. And yeah, this is where the cart was with the tax collector. So we're gonna have to build a wall, I think. What we'll do is we'll build a wall from, that's right, the barracks over here, all the way past the wood logging quarries, straight past, yeah, and we can stop over here at the arena, and we should be pretty well defended if we can just hold that wall. So the walls of Stinterfell are pretty much complete. Oh yeah, let's check them out. Now I've had the invaluable help of the great blacksmith, Sir Beren. How's it going? What do you think? Oh, I love the design. It's just perfect. This rough cobblestone, the dark oak wood, it's just so Stinterfell. I think when Lord Blackwood marches his army down here, he's going to be pooing in his pants. He'll think, how am I going to take these walls? A sound wall, stalwart and strong, to keep your enemies at bay. That's, oh yeah, it's so good. I can still fly, right? Have I still got my, yeah, still got my my wings? So let's just take a look at these walls. Oh, these look amazing. They look a bit bare, but they definitely do the job. Unless you can think of anything else we could like add to them, I don't know. You can help? What do you mean? What do you mean, Beren? Speak. Something I've had in preparation for your stand. Oh, what's this? Oh, what's this? Heraldic wall banner? What is this? Banners to place along your walls? Like, on the wall? How does this work? Let's try and put one along the front. So what, like, here? It's blank. These are blank. What good's that? Well, what's this? Heraldic scroll. What does this do? It's a scroll of arms. Oh, whoa, look at this. Oh, wow, so we can like redesign. Wait, hang on a sec. Yeah, this looks exactly like, oh yeah, this is perfect. In fact, let's match this to our banner right here, because I think, yeah. Oh, this is perfect. Yeah, let's just plop this on these banners. So how does it work? You right click with this on the banner and it just becomes your sigil. Oh, that is perfect. And we can splash these along here. Oh, this is going to be amazing. Hope we've got enough. 27. Oh, and what I can do is also I can splash these around town to decorate. So everyone that lives here, even though they probably already know exactly where they live, just to make sure that they have like, you know, that swelling pride in their hearts that they belong to the kingdom of Stinterfell. And that no matter what they do, no matter who invades, whether it's Blackwood or any of his cronies, they'll always be protected by the armies of Stinterfell. Now this is just a bare bones fort because we haven't got long, I'm assuming, until Blackwood's armies march on us. So this should be enough to kind of hold him at bay. We can come back, now that I can fly, we can come back and add in some extra kind of little bits. Like some fortifications, some towers, and a bit more detail and panache to go along the walls. But for the time being, I definitely reckon this is something we can defend. What we need though now is troops along these walls. Now the problem is with troops, swords are not a ranged weapon. So if we put our grunts along the wall, they're not going to be able to hold off the forces of evil, the forces of Blackwood. What we need are some archers. Now archers are notoriously bad shots. If you've ever seen our champion archer, Theron Badshot, or he's a mediocre shot now, but if you've ever seen him go to work, you'll realize that, yeah, Archery is something that NPCs are pretty bad at, so we're going to need to have loads and loads and loads of archery NPCs dotted along these walls. So let's go and make ourselves some archer soldiers. Right, so we have 5 stacks of gold plus 22, and that should be more than enough to make enough archers to line our walls. So thanks for gathering up all the gold, Baron. This is going to come in super handy. So just grab out a whole bunch of gold. And now let's get to the engineering station and start creating some archers to go on our walls. We'll need some food bundles, some wooden swords. Oh yeah, but this should be no problem at all. Right, so I've made 52 combat NPCs, but we're going to put one down to start with. Right click, give him a bow. Bam, he's suddenly an archer. Great stuff. Now we need to give him a name. So we're going to call him Stjintafell Archer. But now we also need to give him a skin. So I've looked up what skins we've got available. Let's try Archer. What does that look like? That is the... Oh, now that looks like a badass archer. Look, his eyes are covered. But honestly, let's face it. Who really needs to see when they're shooting out at enemies? These archers are so bad, it almost suits them that they can't see what they're shooting at. All right, let's pack him up and duplicate this 51 times. We'll get 51 bows and get 51 archers littered across these walls, ready to fight. But I also have to set up some town halls behind them so these guys don't have to travel too far to get some food to keep themselves stocked up. Right, so that is all of the archers down. Look at these impressive rude dudes. They're all along the wall, and as soon as like a monster appears, they should take him down with like a hail of arrows from these walls. I'm not 100% sure it'll work, so we'll have to test them. Oh, there's Beram. He's not an archer, but I guess with a bow, he could pretend to be. Oh, and this is all looking really good. The banners, the wall. I really can't wait for Blackwood to try something and assault these walls. So until next time, guys, this has been Rule the World. I hope he doesn't appear, but he might do next episode. So we'll have to wait and see. We'll have to get some command batons so we can get our grunts out here to do the dirty work. But we'll have to see what he brings to the table, how many troops he brings to war. So until next time, guys, take care.